Soho Karen. I talked about her months ago. Can't really remember. She did that really amazing tackle on a black kid. You got to give it to her. I mean, I don't care if he's like, what, 14, 15? He was bigger than she was, and she totally lit his ass up like it was the Super Bowl. Giving credit where credit's due. Sure, she had racist views, but I can't turn my nose up at a good sack.
Oh, my.
Anyway, this was brought to my attention in emails. I can't remember exactly who sent it because I get a lot of emails. And trying to find one message in a sea of messages is like trying to find a needle in a stack of needles. I give up. Anyway, after all these shenanigans, Soho Karen, she's kind of famous, infamous, I should say. Let's watch some stuff where, what?
Police yet? Do you plan on speaking to the police? Are you going to cooperate? Have you spoken to the family
yet? If I was her, I would lean into this You know, if they're like, have you apologized to the police yet? I'd be like, the police. I would have went full NWA. That would have been my move. And why is she always in open-toe shoes? She must love her feet.
Maya, do you have any regrets at all?
You think this was just blown out of proportion?
Yeah, because I just had no comment.
All right. Was it blown out of
proportion? America's amazing. Like, a chick f***s up, and she literally becomes famous, like, overnight. You know, we had Glue Girl, we've got Soho Karen. What's next? My God, in order to get this sort of press, I'll have to burn down an orphanage and shoot a crippled kid in his legs. He won't feel it. He's crippled. I'm not that bad. That'll be my defense.
What portion do you think?
Just in case.
All right.
All right, now Mia's in the airport. This is a little old.
About what you did? You have a drinking problem, Mia?
No.
What's that in your hand?
Do you have a drinking problem, Mia? No! Isn't she carrying a drink right now?
Are you gonna plead guilty?
That looks like alcohol to me. Unless, like, she has a lemon in her Sprite that just happens to be something she carries around. She's like Julian from the Trailer Park Boys right now.
Do you have any comment to make?
Go away! Stop following me, how about that?
Do you have any comment? Why did you think that guy stole your phone?
Oh my God, did she really just say he stole the phone? I guess this is right before before or after she did the interview where she was like, oh, they found my phone. Oh boy.
So are you happy? What do you think? Do you have an alcohol problem? Do you have an alcohol problem?
I do not. Please stop. Okay, this is my bubble.
Are you having alcohol?
Good God. It's probably gotta suck to have this sort of press on you all the time. You know, I should quit YouTube and just be like a paparazzi. It seems real easy. I'll just like follow around someone who's remotely famous and ask them stupid questions. What are you wearing? What color are your panties? That'd be the question I want to know. Why do you always have open-toe shoes? Are you feeling your oats right now? When you tackled that kid, did you feel like you won the Super Bowl? I would have dropped my elbow in his head.
Do you like fighting with the cops? Huh? How was your weekend?
Can you move?
Why did you choose a...
Obviously, Mia has an alcohol problem. She's had two DW motherfucking eyes. Why would you ask... Do you have an alcohol problem? The answer is yes. Ask a better question. What's your favorite drink? Do you like gin and tonic? What do you think of rum and coke?
Why did you choose a black kid? Huh? Why did you choose a black...
Why did you choose a black kid? She should have been like, because he looks suspicious. He came in there looking like Lil Wayne.
Why do you think that kid took your phone? Because he was black?
No, because he did.
He took your phone? Where did he learn from all these? Yeah.
These guys do suck. I should be a paparazzi. These questions suck. Hey, Nadia, do you wear a bra? Because I don't think you need one. Are you doing OnlyFans? Can I get a free subscription? Anyway, this video surfaced recently of Mia getting arrested by the cops for being wild as shit. If there's ever a point in your life where women tell you like they got it hard, believe me, they don't. Just watching her fight with the cops and not once did they shake her ass up like a dry martini is genuinely amazing.
Yeah, can you see? Can I see your warrant? Where's your warrant? Yeah, give me a warrant. Give me your warrant.
Mia starts off yelling at the damn cop going, where's your warrant? This proves to you she doesn't know the law. Unfortunately, when you're a minority, you need to know some level of the law. Because you're dealing with the police. Number one, You can't go, where's your warrant? Mia, you don't live at the gas station, girl. Two, she was charged with DWI, resisting arrest, and obstructing, delaying a peace officer or EMT. Her blood alcohol level was twice the legal limit. Oh, that girl. That's the girl. You date a girl like her, she's gonna f*** your life up.
Wrong. You are just coming here for no reason. Oh my god. You are just detaining me for no reason. I'm not even touching you. You are asking.
That has to be the nicest police takedown I've ever seen in my life. It was the most docile, slow. Usually when the cops are tackling a black man, they're trying to get his head to hit the concrete so he's knocked the fuck out. Wasn't there a black girl at a school who got thrown down by a cop head first and knocked out? Yeah. Like with Mia, they gently lay her on the ground. The mother's built like Danny DeVito. That's what's really tragic in all of this. The dude who's filming this seems to be the most level-headed in the situation.
I just asked that you don't touch me, please and thank you.
Oh my god.
He's telling you more than five times now. You should please listen.
Oh my god, this chick is wild. This chick is wild. She's wild and annoying. It's a dangerous combination. You know what this reminds me of? An episode of Reno 911. I don't know if you've ever seen that. It used to be a Comedy Central show way back when Comedy Central occasionally put on something remotely funny. This is that. Literally watching. I got nothing for this. It's hard to get through. This is just like I'm watching a loony ass woman go out of her way to be obnoxious. Like, just fucking comply with the damn cops. Call you here. Get out the next day, unless it's the weekend.
You're treating me like I'm literally like a criminal. I didn't do anything. Ow! I'm not even laughing. I'm like, I just think you guys are like a joke. There are like gang members that are killing people right now, and you're arrested.
You gotta love Mia. You really do. The girl is literally screaming, "I'm not doing anything," while resisting arrest the whole time. The whole time. I'm not doing anything except resisting arrest. I love that part. Mia just goes in and says there's gang members killing people right now and you're arresting a girl. Her excuse for everything she does is she's a girl. I'd hate to be the man that marries her. I swear to Christ. Everything would be, I'm a girl. Take out the trash, I'm a girl. Wash the dishes, I'm a girl. Make dinner for the children. I'm a girl. Pay the bills. I'm a girl, you idiot. It's amazing her didn't fall out of that top, but there ain't much there to begin with. Just an observation. There's even a female officer in the mix now. I can't take this. It's a terrible video. I'm watching Mia Paulsetto just be an asshole for like 2 minutes straight. Again. Like the girl's habitually a line stepper. Even with the interview she did with Good Morning America, whatever, she was an asshole. You see her get arrested by the cops and she's as drunk. She an asshole. You see her? Technically, she has every right to be an asshole to the Pavarazzi. I'm going to have to side with her there. You're just trying to drink your rum and coke or your gin and Sprite. Asshole sitting there asking you for a drinking problem when he obviously sees you got a drink in your hand. I'm just tired. I can't. There's nothing funny here. It's literally watching a chick be an asshole and totally the cops don't rough her up. Nobody puts their knee in her throat. Nobody throws her head into the concrete like they did a black girl a little while ago. It's just like amazing. It's genuinely amazing. Wait, she's also being probed for smashing an Airbnb door with a fire extinguisher the same day as her scuffle with the Keon Harold Jr. So basically, you're telling me after she tackles the black kid, she goes to her Airbnb and smashes the door with a fire extinguisher. Who the fuck is this girl? Bon Scott from AC/DC? This girl just, she can't stop. She's a wild animal. Like, the fact she's been involved in all this bullshit and is totally out and free. I know if I got caught for half of this, if I, like, tackled a teenager into the ground and I fought the police on, like, one or two arrests, then I smashed up an Airbnb, they lock my ass up and throw away the key. She's hotter than Tech 969 or whatever the hell his name is. He talks shit and has, like, bodyguards protect him. Mia Ponsetto breaks free from men and tackles another dude. Is she a woman? Mia Ponsetto fighting with the cops. Tech 69, whatever his name is, rat motherfucker out. He's like, officer, I will comply with the law and tell you who did it.